Hi guys, welcome back. In this lecture, we'll learn an important concept named Storyboard References. As you can see, all view controllers are now squeezed in our start storyboard. This makes things difficult to work with, especially when the app grows or you work as a team. A great way to deal with this is to use Storyboard References, which is a new feature in Xcode 7. Basically, we split a big storyboard into smaller ones containing certain groups of view controllers, then link them using Storyboard References. As we did in one of the previous lectures, we deleted the default main storyboard and replaced it by a new storyboard, which we named Start Storyboard. The reason we name it Start Storyboard is that it should only contain the view controllers, such as Splash, Login, or Signup View controllers. Basically, what users just interact with occasionally. And this tab bar controller, which contains the view controllers that users interact with frequently. That should be placed in a separate storyboard. So we select the tab bar controller along with all contained UI view controllers. Then in the editor menu, choose Refactor into Storyboard. Basically, we're splitting out the tab bar controller into a new storyboard. Let's name this new storyboard Main. This step is subjective. You're free to name it as you like. Okay, good. A new storyboard was created, which contains the lab bar controller and its UI view controller. By the way, things look a bit disorganized now. Let's make them a bit more attractive. This step is just something personal and completely optional. It doesn't really have anything to do with the app. It might take a bit, but things will look much more well-organized. So, just bear with me. Alright, we're almost done. Yep, perfect. This is our new main storyboard, which contains the tab bar controller. Later on, we'll divide the storyboard further by splitting out each of the UI view controllers into a separate storyboard. Now, if you notice, there's an arrow pointing to the tab controller. This means the tab bar controller is the initial view controller of this main storyboard. If you turn to the start storyboard, you see another arrow pointing to the login view controller. This means the login view controller is the initial one for this start storyboard. If you build the app now, this login view will show up first. So how does the app decide which initial view controller displays first? Turns out, if you choose the project in the navigator, you'll see the main interface in the deployment info is set to the start storyboard by default. So when the app runs, it will look at this main interface and look for the initial view controller of this storyboard. Let's run the app to confirm what we've just discussed. If you want to display the tab bar view instead, simply change the main interface. Okay, here it is. The login view shows up first indeed. Everything is still the same. Alright, this little box is the storyboard reference. It is now the target of the two segues, which are represented by these arrows. In its attribute inspector, there's a reference ID attribute. The placeholder text in there tells us what the storyboard reference points to if we don't say anything. By the way, you can hold Option and then select the main storyboard on the navigator. An assistant editor will show up, which offers us a broader view. In the main storyboard, the tab bar is set up to be the initial view controller in its attribute inspector. So the storyboard reference is now pointing to this tab bar controller. And in turn, this tab bar controller is the target of the segues from the login and the signup view. If we drop this initial view controller, Xcode will complain. The error kind of says the storyboard reference that we've created is pointing to nothing. Because it points to the initial view controller of the new storyboard by default, but there isn't one. So we need to specify where this storyboard reference points to. We can either assign an initial view controller to the new storyboard, then let it point to this initial one by default. Or we can, from the attribute selector of the storyboard reference, explicitly tell it what to point to via the reference ID attribute. This reference ID is an ID assigned to the view controller we want to reference, and we want the reference to point to. Now, we can look for anything related to ID in the identity inspector of the object. For this tab bar controller, we assign this ID to the storyboard attribute in its attribute inspector. Note that this ID must distinguish from the storyboard ID of any other subjects or objects. So let's choose something meaningful and unique. Here, we set it to tab bar ID. It's not a great one, but it does this job. Now, simply go to the attribute inspector of the storyboard reference and explicitly tell it to point to the controller with this ID in the new storyboard. Again, the placeholder text shows that if we say nothing, it points to the initial view controller. All right, good. You can now see exactly where the storyboard reference is pointing to. By the way, this is a great feature of Xcode. It makes our projects much more organized and helps avoid all kinds of conflicts for a team project. Okay, here's the app. Yep, the login view controller segues to the storyboard reference, which in turn segues to the tab bar controller. By the way, this warning is just an Xcode bug, so don't worry about it. All right, we'll work more on storyboard references next time. See you then!